Good morning. My name is Bruce Stallings. I'm the executive pastor here at Briarwood Presbyterian Church, and this year the acting interim superintendent for the school, and I enjoy getting to interact with the school, and this is one of my favorite programs of all time. The Three Tall Trees, I love that we do this program. I love that we do it in kindergarten because it so depicts the foundational story of what we want to see the Lord plant deep within these children. We're glad you're here to see it. If you have family or friends that are not here, let me remind you that it is live streamed. And so you could just shoot them a text and say, hey, go to briarwood.org and click on live stream, and they'll be able to watch the program. So if you wanted to send that to someone, that would certainly be appropriate for them. We'd love to have them here. I'm not going to encourage you to enjoy the program because that's a given. I know that you're going to enjoy the program, but let me encourage you to do this. This is the story of all stories. I would strongly encourage you to get your children to explain this story to you. I know you're going to want to tell them how much you enjoyed them doing the program, how much you enjoyed it, but get them to explain it to you and have a conversation with them, because this is the story that changes all of everyone's life. And so encourage them to do that. We pray that this story, the Lord plants deep in their heart and it impacts them for all of their life. Thank you for being here.
May we pray. Dear God, thank you so much for this day. Thank you how you love us and take care of us. Thank you for this wonderful day that we had and this wonderful night. I hope that everyone does a good job at Three Tall Trees, and we all glorify you and honor you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Once upon a mountaintop, long, long ago, there were three little trees. They stood straight and as tall as they could, and they looked down on the towns in the valley below. Every day, these three little trees dreamed about what they wanted to be. Up into the night sky above her and saw all the stars twinkling and shining like diamonds. The first tree said,
I want to hold treasure. I want to be decorated with gold and filled with diamonds and jewels. I will be the most beautiful treasure chest in the world. What?
second tree looked out on the river in the valley below. The river led to a great big ocean. The second tree said,
I want to be a big, strong sailing ship. I want to sail on mighty waters and carry important kings. I will be the strongest ship in the world. I want to be a ship, a big, strong sailing ship. I'll carry kings and other things, a big, strong sailing ship.
I want to be a ship, a big, strong sailing ship. I'll carry kings and other things, a big, strong sailing ship.
The third tree looked down at the valley and the town below. She saw all the busy people working there. The third tree said,
I want to be the tallest tree of all. I want to be so tall that people will look up at me. And when they lift their eyes to heaven, I want them to think about God.
Began to grow, standing straight and tall, and together they would sing this song. Many years came and went. The sun shone and the rains came. The three little trees on the mountaintop grew tall and straight. One day, they saw three woodcutters climbing up the mountain. The first woodcutter looked at the first tree and said,
"This is a beautiful tree. X is right for me."
The woodcutter's shining axe glistened in the morning sun as he chopped down the first tree. Now she would be a beautiful treasure chest. The second woodcutter looked at the second tree and said,
"This is a strong tree. It's just right for me."
The woodcutter's shining axe glistened in the morning sun as he cut down the second tree. Now she would be a big, strong sailing ship. Now when the third woodcutter looked at the third tree, her heart sank. She stood as tall as she could, and her branches pointed bravely up to heaven. But the woodcutter didn't even care. The third woodcutter looked at the third tree and said,
"Any old tree will do for me. This one will be just fine."
The woodcutter's axe glistened in the morning sun as he cut down the third tree. Now she would never get her dream to be the tallest tree of all.
Tree was happy when she was brought to the shipyard. But instead of becoming a big, strong ship, the one strong tree was made into a simple fishing boat.
Too little for the big ocean, she was brought into a small lake where every day she helped bring in loads of fish.
Many nights and days went by, and the three tall trees almost forgot their dreams. Then one night, golden starlight poured down over the first tree as a newborn baby was placed in the feed box. And the mother said,
"This is a beautiful manger to hold our baby."
"Yes, it is beautiful, Mary."
Right then, the first tree smiled because she knew that she was holding the greatest treasure in all the world. one night, years later, a tired man and his friends got into the fishing boat and went out onto the lake. The tired man soon fell asleep as the second tree carried them all quietly across the water. Suddenly, a wild storm came up, and the second tree was afraid she would not be strong enough to carry her passengers through all the wind and rain. The tired man continued to sleep, and his frightened friends began to shout at him.
Wake up, Jesus! Wake up!
The tired man awoke and spoke to his friends. Stretched out his hands and said,
"Hey, be still!"
Suddenly, the storm stopped just like that. And right then, the second tree smiled down deep because she knew that she was carrying the King of heaven and earth. Then, one Friday morning, the third tree's beams were carried by a beaten, tired man through a crowd of angry, jeering people. Humiliated and embarrassed, the third tree was dragged along the dusty streets to the top of a hill. The third tree felt ugly and cruel as soldiers nailed the beaten man's hands and feet to her. The third tree's heart was broken, and she began to sadly sing. During the afternoon, the crucified man died upon the arms of the third tree. The dead man was taken down and placed in a tomb nearby. The third tree felt ashamed that she had been the cause of such suffering and pain. on Sunday morning, the sun rose and the third tree stood alone, tall and straight on the hill. She felt the earth shake beneath her, and she knew that God's love had conquered everything. It had made the first tree beautiful, the second tree strong, and every time people saw the third tree, they would think about God. That was even better than being the tallest tree in the world, and now she could sing this song. Because Jesus died and rose again for us, we can have God's forgiveness for our sins and eternal life with Him in heaven. If we turn from our own way and commit ourselves to Christ as our Lord and Savior, we will also know Him as our personal source of true liberty, daily victory, and deep happiness. Won't you choose Him this very day?
Thank you.
First of all, boys and girls, thank you. Thank you so very much. You did an outstanding job today of sharing the truth of who Jesus Christ really is, and that he is alive today, and that he died for us. He rose again so that we may live forever in heaven with him. Thank you. Thank you for your excellence. Thank you for your hard work. And thank you for giving us the gift of your performance today. May we please give them another round of applause. At this time, we would like to say thank you to some of our friends that have helped us to have this performance today. We have, okay. So we want to thank, first of all, we want to thank Mrs. Lynn Trotter. Thank you, Ms. Trotter, for directing this performance. Thank you. Ms. Nixon, thank you for your excellence in helping us perform today. We would also like to stop and thank Frank Barker III for helping us. And our parents, I want you to know we also would like to thank Sergeant Powell today for helping us to keep us safe. Thank you, Sergeant Powell. At this time, boys and girls, we are going to let your teachers come up and take you back to the classrooms, and in a few minutes, your parents will meet you there. Teachers, would you like to come up and help your children dismiss? While they are walking back, I wanted to let you know there are forms in the bookstore so that you may order a DVD for this performance. And at this time, I will close us in prayer. Dear Father God in heaven, we thank you, Father God, most of all for your Son, Jesus Christ. We thank you for this opportunity that we have received this morning to hear the gospel of the truth of your Son, Jesus Christ, how he came to live on earth, how he suffered, how he died, how he sacrificed, so that we may be saved and that we may be forgiven for our sin. These children have been given the opportunity to know the truth, to hear the truth, and Father, give that blessing of the truth to all who have seen and heard it today. We pray, Father God, that that truth will be sent out, that hearts will be softened, and they would come to you, and they would know you as their Lord and Savior. Thank you for this day, and thank you, Father God, for your Son, Jesus Christ. It's in his name we pray. Amen. Thank you for coming today. We hope you were as blessed as I have been in receiving the truth of who Jesus Christ truly is today. Thank you for being here, and we hope that you have a wonderful Easter time and a wonderful spring break. Thank you. And